Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2336. Where are the data type fields stored? Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, I've been thinking a lot about data types recently, primarily because they've already publicly announced that there's a great new feature coming, and they say it's coming this spring, the spring of 2020, and here we are. It's June 19th. There's only like one day left until spring, and I get it. They're running late, coronavirus, no one working in the office. They say that I'll put a link to this blog post down in the YouTube description down there. They say they're coming out with 100 new data types, like chemistry, food, movie, places, even Pokemon. I don't know why we need Pokemon in Excel. But the whole thing with these 100 new data types, discussion here, and especially after that episode 2332, where I was doing an XLOOKUP into a single column of data types, you know, where is it being stored? Is Excel running out to the internet every single time we do that, or does it run out to the internet once and store the data in the file? I said, well, wait, there's a simple way we can figure this out. So I have three cities here on the data tab. I'm gonna come in and mark this as geography. All right, it worked. I'm not gonna pull any data out. We just have the map icon there. This is called three data type cells. I'll click save and then close. We'll come out to that folder where that's stored. All right, now first thing we have to do, if you've never changed this setting, and I always change this setting, go into View, Options, Change Folder and Search Options. Under View, uncheck the box for Hide Extensions for Known File Types. Click OK. That allows us to see that this is a .xlsx file. And to crack this open, right-click, rename, and change it from xlsx to .zip. And they warn you, hey, it might become unusable. No, it's really okay. It's going to be fine. All right, so we have a zip file here. That's all an XLSX file really is a zip file. Double click to open that. And the XL folder here, I'm going to go into that. And then rich data, data types, we're originally called rich data. And we now have 6 different XML files. So let's just take one of these. This, I'll copy, Control C. Come out here to the folder, right click, and paste. All right, and then we'll take a look at what's inside of this. So we're going to edit this. All right, and there it is. Okay, so remember I had Miami, and so now they're stored in here. The URL to the picture of Miami with the description of image of Miami. It says that it's in Florida. It's here's the description. So all of this data that backs up those data types is stored right inside the workbook. Down in the XL folder and the rich data types. It's there. It's right in the folder. And then another question on that YouTube video about the XLOOKUP, someone said, well, wait a second. Do we need to have the internet every time we want to do this XLOOKUP? No. You only have to have the internet when you create the data type, and then all of the data is stored right there in the file. So that's kind of cool, I think. I really hope by now we'd be able to take a look at these new data types with food, movie, places. If you're on the beta channel, which used to be called Insiders Fast, you know, just check every couple of days here under data and see if something new pops in. It should be really cool when it comes along. Now, if you like these tips, please, right down there below the video, click subscribe and ring that bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below. My new book, Mr. Excel 2020, Seeing Excel Clearly, it's an ebook now. We'll be printing it later on. Click that I in the top right-hand corner for more information. Well, look, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.